Testament scripture today is found on page 1771 in your Bibles, 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verses 1 through 9. Getting into the book. Paul, called to be an apostle of Christ Jesus by the will of God, and our brother Sosthenes, to the church of God in Corinth, to those sanctified in Christ Jesus and called to be his holy people, together with all those everywhere who call on the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, their Lord and ours. Grace and peace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I always thank my God for you because of his grace given you in Christ Jesus. For in him you have been enriched in every way, with all kinds of speech and with all knowledge, God thus confirming our testimony about Christ among you. Therefore you do not lack any spiritual gifts as you eagerly await for your Lord, our Lord Jesus Christ, to be revealed. He will also keep you firm to the end, so that you will be blameless on the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. God is faithful, who has called you into fellowship with his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Good morning.
Good morning.
We've come to our time of sharing of joys and concerns, and Christopher is going to be coming around with the microphone, so if you have a joy or a concern, please raise your hand and you can share it with us. Do you have any joys or concerns to share this morning?
Well, I wanted to tell everybody that Jim and I now have 13 grandchildren. We have a grandson born on Thursday. His name is Zeke Matthew. And we're tired because we've been taking care of the five other grandchildren in that family. So everybody's doing well.
Congratulations, yes. Jim and Barbara. Do you have other joys or concerns this morning, Linda? While Christopher moves around, I'll update a couple of things. Dean McCann asks prayers for her cousin, Jessie Gay Johnson, who had a stroke. She lives in Salt Lake City. She had a stroke last week. She has gone to the hospital, is now in rehab, and she's having a hard time speaking. So please, prayers for Jessie Gay Johnson. Yeah, Kim?
On behalf of the youth and the youth leaders, I want to report that we had a great lock-in Friday night. We had 21 youth and seven adult leaders. I want to thank everyone that donated the blankets. We ended up making 11 blankets for the homeless people. We made seven containers and baked cookies for our shut-ins. And we also made over 27 bags of cookies for the homeless people as well. So thank you all who donated everything. And we did 50 Valentines that we're going to take to the VA hospital. So thank you.
Thank you all. Good work to our youth and our youth leaders in service to our community. What are choices and concerns left out this morning?
We still need prayers for Adam and his mom. His mom is still in the hospital, still sedated. They're supposed to be waking her up soon. Hoping that the double pneumonia will have cured and diabetes will be under control and her heart will be working as well. But they still need lots of prayers.
Certainly lots of prayers for Carol Setzer and Adam Setzer as they're preparing to wake her up from week and a half sedation. Her kidneys are functioning better, but she's still having a lot of troubles breathing, so prayers for her. Yes, Karen?
I have a good friend, her name is Melody Alsa, her mother died this week, very suddenly. She's lived with her mother for a long time, and she's just really having a hard time, so I'd like prayers for my friend Melody.
Karen McLean's friend Melody, who lost her mother very suddenly, she lived with this past week, so prayers for Melody.
Just a quick word to thank you all for your care and support in the passing of Joanne's dad. The Surgery Church showed again that this was so wonderful in that regard. We appreciate all your support, cards, care, food, etc., and visits. And the service we had at Hill Christian Church last Monday was really a beautiful service. Those of you that were there, I think you'll agree. We really did have a great ongoing Thursday. So thank you for your support and care.
You will certainly keep Ross and Joe.